Again, welcome back. Attorney Steve Vondran, the real estate lawyer, and we're back talking in this video about the contract for deed in Arizona. Contract for deed. You can't even say it. It's so complex. The contract for deed in Arizona. So without further ado, let's head to the Attorney Steve real estate whiteboard. Okay, so we've got the contract for deed up on the board here. This is a unique principle. It comes under ARS 33-741 and ARS 33-750. You can read all about it. You can go to askattorneysteve.com, get more information, and just type in contract for deed into our search bar. You'll find it, okay? So let's say you want to buy an office building that's $500,000, okay? This is our price here, $500,000. A little small office building, 4 or 5 units in it. Neat little investment for you. $500,000, but you only have $250,000 down. You don't have the greatest credit, and you say, you know what? I just know I can make this thing work. It's going to be a good amortized investment over the long haul. But you got $250,000 down. You can't find a loan for the other $250,000, so you go to the seller right here, and you say, seller, will you do a contract for deed for me? Will you help me finance this? Will you carry the financing, so to speak? These are also known as installment contracts, sometimes referred to as an installment contract, where you're going to be paying down this $250,000 over time. And so you're asking the buyer here, is asking the seller here to do a contract for deed. Now the deed is going to be the security. It's going to be the security for the repayment of the $250,000. So it's just like a mortgage. If you don't pay the $250,000, the contract for deed will normally give the rights to the seller, the vendor, also known as the vendor and the vendee here. These are fun little legal terms for you. So the buyer and the seller will contract for the deed to pay the $250,000. Now, what happens? Some people say, well, who has legal title? Well, the buyer is going to get what we call the equitable title. They're going to have the rights to do things on the property, so forth and so on, subject to the terms of this contract. This contract could spell out all kinds of things. So the buyer, the vendee, is going to get equitable title. The seller, the vendee, is going to get legal title. They're going to hold legal title. In Arizona, it's a title theory state, so this lender here is going to hold the title. They have an equitable interest. The seller has the legal interest. Now, and also this is supported under what we call the doctrine of equitable conversion, which basically says the seller is holding the title for in trust for the buyer, and the buyer is holding the money, the payments, the $250,000 in trust for the seller. So this is what we call our doctrine of equitable conversion. Arizona title theory state. We have vendor, vendee. So we're getting some great terms out here. We're learning some wonderful, powerful real estate terms. And we have our contract for deed. Okay, so you're going to check that out. You got your code sections. Now, what happens when you pay off the $250,000? Hooray! I got the $250,000 paid off. So by law, by the statute, if you go look it up, when you're done paying that, the seller, the vendor needs to issue the payoff deed. The payoff deed, the big words, that's what you want, the payday, the gravy train. And that basically, when that happens, that will basically vest the full legal title in the buyer, in the vendee. So that's basics how it works. If you need some help with some transactional issues, some installment contracts, commercial leases, these kinds of things, give us a call. You'll find out more information at askattorneysteve.com. Click on that red V so you keep these videos coming. They're fun, they're informative, and again, feel free to share these on your social media networks. Hope this has been helpful. Attorney Steve, the real estate lawyer. We'll talk to you soon.